I think what it was, people at the time, even though they knew they was going to die, and they sort of hedged their bets. They say, well, if we believe you, can we live forever, please? They go, oh, yeah, they'll die, though, and come back as another creature, about as real as the God you can't see. They go, okay, as long as we come back, though. They've been dead over 2,000 years now, and they haven't come back. Okay, the odd unanswered questions. There are unanswered questions, and we'd like to have answers to them, but we don't. Does that mean that we must insert God in their place? No. It is enough to know that science has been moving the hokum from our life at a steady pace, when allowed. And we don't have to replace science with any form of God. You could ask, what was the first universe in the multi-universe? What is at the beginning of the steady state? When did it first start? Questions such as that. But it doesn't mean you have to, if you don't know, then insert your humanized God. Okay, finding God. Why is God hiding? Some people want to see God, and they're not satisfied with this faith stuff. Just have faith that is in you and out you. They actually want to go and find God. And so what people have done, religious people, for those people, they have hidden God somewhere. Wherever science has said, or facts have turned up and said, here is 100% fact, or 100 there. They've hidden God in the number one after it, or the question mark after. Whatever X, Y, Z is, they had a number one there. That's where their God is hiding. This is to suit the ones that want to find God, and unhappy that they have to rely on faith all the time. They want to actually see the humanized face of God. So in the start, it's like there's a small world, it'd be over the hill. But as man progressed, looked over the hill, he wasn't there. And pretty soon, he was up in the clouds. He was in heaven. So we have pictures of cloud. But then men started to get amongst the clouds, and he wasn't there either. So then he ended up in the stars somewhere, and the telescope sweeped the sky, the night sky, and they couldn't find him. And then he's appeared everywhere and nowhere. He's at the beginning of the Big Bang. He's been shoved over there, or he's in the smallest small particle where you can't find him in there. Or he's just siding in another dimension. Either way, for those who go looking, who perhaps they shouldn't be looking, they will not find him, because he isn't there.